rearrangement. So we have seen when is a series said to be absolutely convergent. So a series is said to be series un is summation un. It's nothing but u1, u2 and so on up to un and so on. This series is said to be absolutely convergent. If absolutely convergent, if summation mod un converges. And suppose un summation un converges and summation mod un does not converge. Mod un does not converge, then summation un is said to be conditionally convergent. Conditionally convergent. This is for alternating series. That is, the series may contain positive or negative terms. But if the series contains, there are two cases. If the series summation un is a series of positive terms, then whichever way you arrange the terms of the series, then rearrangement of the series, if the series is convergent, then rearrangement of series is also convergent. It will not change the nature of the, it will not alter the nature of the convergence of the series. Rearrangement of series is also convergent. See, for example, if we take summation un as 1 plus 1 by 2 square, 1 by 3 square and so on, 1 by n square plus and so on. Summation un, if we take, this is nothing but summation 1 by n square. We know that this series is convergent because it is in the form 1 by n power p, where p is equal to 2 is greater than 1. Therefore, by auxiliary series test, or it is also called p test, by auxiliary series test, summation un converges whenever p is greater than 1. Therefore, summation un converges. Here we can see that all the terms are positive terms. But if it is that, even if we rearrange, what is the rearrangement? Writing the terms, dislocating the orders will not affect the convergence. Because wherever we write, that is summation un 1 by 2 square plus 1 by 1 square or 1 by 3 square, such that the original, all the terms which are present in this series, if they are present in this series also, it is called as a rearrangement of the given series. So, irrespective of the order in which they appear in this, irrespective of that, still the given series of positive terms still becomes, this is called rearrangement. What is going to be rearrangement without disturbing the terms? That is, what are all the terms that are present in this? Are present in this, then the resulting series is what is called as rearrangement of the given series. That is, we are only changing the location of the numbers, that is terms. So then in that case also, this is automatically convergent. So the convergence, the nature of the series is not altered by altering the, that is the terms, rearrangement of the terms, rearranging the terms is not affected if the series is of positive terms. But if it is conditionally convergent, then definitely if we change the order, the rearrangement changes not only the order, it changes the sum also. When we try to find what is the sum of this series, in case of positive term series, not only the nature of the series is the same, the sum value also remains fixed, that is constant. That is, the rearrangement of the series, the sum of the rearrangement of the series is same as sum of the given series. And the nature is also same. It is not altered because of rearrangement. But if the series is conditionally convergent, that means if the terms are alternatively positive and negative, then in that case, rearrangement of the series affects not only the nature, it affects even the sum also. Let us work out one problem based on this. Take down. Let's prove that the series. Prove that the series 1 plus 1 by 2 minus 1 by 3 plus 1 by 4 plus 1 by 5 minus 1 by 6 plus and so on is divergent while the series 1 plus 1 by 2 minus 2 by 3 plus 1 by 4 plus 1 by 5 minus 2 by 6 plus 1 by 7 plus 1 by 7 plus 1 by 8 minus 2 by 9 plus and so on converges and the sum is ln 3. So prove that the series so rearranging the given series, the series can be expressed in this particular form. So when you express the series in this particular form, summation union, that is 1 plus 1 by 2 minus 1 by 3 plus 1 by 4 plus 1 by 5 minus 1 by 6 plus and so on. Rearranging the series 1 plus 1 by 2 minus, this is writing the series in this particular form, we get nth term. What is the nth term of all the first terms is, this is 1 by 1, 1 by 4, next term is 1 by 7. So all the first terms when you consider, this is in arithmetic progression, 1, 4, 7 and so on. This is 1 plus n minus 1 into d, this is 3n minus 2. So the nth term for all the first terms is 3n minus 2. For all the second terms, when we look at it, it is 1 by 2, 1 by 5 and so on. So it is again, that is 2 comma, 5 comma and so on. Then what is the nth term is 2 plus n minus 1 into 3. This is 2 plus 3n minus 3, which is 3n minus 1. 1 by 3n minus 1. When we look at the last terms, there are multiples of 3n. So we get this. This is the summation of un, n ranging from 1 to infinity. This is sum plus n. So this is the nth term, un. Nth term of this series is this. Now, let us take a ur. What is ur? Is 1 by 3n minus 2 plus 1 by 3n minus 1 minus 1 by 3 n at n equal to r. 3r minus 1. So the given series is, so given series 1 plus 1 by 2 minus 1 by 3. This is the given series and so on. This is nothing but equal to summation un. That is n equal to 1. This is nothing but summation 1 by 3n minus 2 plus 1 by 3n minus 1 minus 1 by 3. This is summation un, n ranging from 1 to infinity. Now what is our ur is this. Let sn be equal to summation partial sum, nth partial of ur. That means u1, u2 and so on up to un. That is nothing but summation r is equal to 1 to n 1 by 3r minus 2, 1 by 3r minus 1, minus 1 by 3r. We know that the series is convergent if the sequence formed by the nth partial sum is convergent. And the series is divergent if the series formed by, the sequence formed by nth partial sum is divergent. So a series is convergent only when the corresponding sequence formed by the nth partial sum is convergent, and this is divergent if the sequence formed by the nth partial sum is divergent. So we have taken the nth partial sum of this. Now this can be rewritten in the form, we can rewrite this as r equal to 1 to n 1 by 3r minus 2 1 by 3r minus 1 minus 1 by 3r. This can be rewritten as 1 by 3r minus 2 by 3. We can rewrite. Now we can rewrite this as summation. We can rewrite this as summation summation r is equal to 1 to n 1 by 3r minus 2 plus 1 by 3r minus 1 plus 1 by 3r minus 2 by 3 summation 1 by r, r ranging from 1 to n. Now we know that this is summation, this is due sum number 1. We know that summation 1 by n is nothing but equal to hn. And hn is nothing but, according to definition, this is 1 by n, that is nothing but summation 1 by n, where there is a value gamma n, that is called Euler constant. That is, gamma n is nothing but hn minus nn, and this is standard result. This gamma n is, as n tends to infinity, where what is gamma is, gamma n approaches a fixed constant gamma, this is called Euler constant, which is a constant fixed value, finite value. So this is the relation between gamma n, the Euler function, and this. So we make use of this relation, and as n tends to infinity, gamma n approaches a finite value gamma, which is a fixed constant called Euler constant. So we use that. So according to that, this is nothing but our Sn. Sn is nothing but equal to, this total is nothing but H3n minus 2 by 3 into, that is nothing but Hn up to nth term. This is nothing but H3n, according to this, is nothing but, what is Hn? So this implies Hn is gamma n plus ln n. So applying this, H3n will be gamma 3n plus ln 3n minus 2 by 3 into Hn. Hn is nothing but gamma n plus ln n. So applying this, we get that this is gamma 3n plus ln 3 plus ln n minus 2 by 3 gamma n minus 2 by 3 ln n. So this implies this is gamma 3n plus ln 3 plus ln n. Ln n and these two together, this is nothing but ln 3 is constant. These two, when we simplify, we get 1 third ln n minus 2 by 3 gamma n. Now when we take the limit, when do we say that the series is convergent? If and only the sequence is convergent. When is sequence convergent? If the nth partial sum, that is approaches, that is the limit of the nth partial sum, when is sequence going to be convergent? If the limit of the sequence is finite and unique. Limit of the sequence is defined as limit of its nth term. So what is the nth term of that sequence is Sn. So we find out limit Sn, limit entering into infinity of, we get this as gamma 3n plus ln 3 minus minus 2 by 3 gamma n plus 1 by 3 ln n. We say that the sequence Sn is convergent if the limit of the nth term, that is limit of the sequence is limit of its nth term, then if this limit is finite and unique, then only we say it is convergent. If we get infinity or minus infinity, we say it is divergent. Applying that, gamma 3n limit is gamma, ln 3 means ln 3, this is gamma, but this goes to 1 by 3 limit ln, and limit ln log infinity is infinity, so this goes to, therefore the sequence Sn is divergent, because limit of the nth term is infinity, this is divergent. If the sequence formed by nth partial sum is divergent, we say that the corresponding series is also divergent according to the definition. Also divergent. Okay. Then we have summation un is divergent. That's what we are asked to prove. What is summation un? It is nothing but the given question. What is the given question? 1 plus 1 by 2 minus 1 by 3 plus 1 by 4 plus 1 by 5 minus 1 by 6 and so on is divergent. Now we have to prove that. We have to prove that the next series is convergent. What is the next series? We are asked to prove that the series. First, one part we have completed. They are asked to show that the series 1 plus 1 by 2 minus 2 by 3 plus 1 by 4 plus 1 by 5 minus 2 by 6 plus 1 by 7 plus 1 by 8 minus 2 by 9 and so on is divergent. They are asked to prove that this is convergent and the limit is ln 3. This is what we are asked to prove. Now, when we look at this, first terms are same, 1, 1 by 4, 1 by 3. So, this series, this can be written as summation un, which is equal to summation, the nth term for all the first terms is same as that, 3n minus 2. For all the second terms, 1 by 2, 1 by 5, it is same as that, 1 by 3n minus 1. But last term, we get it as minus 2 by 3n. 2 by 3, 2 by 6, 2 by 9, nth term is this. Now, let us take a UR. UR is nothing but 1 by 3R minus 2 plus 1 by 3R minus 1 minus 2 by 3. So, consider Sn. Let Sn be equal to, this is the nth partial sum of this infinite series and it is R, R ranging from 1 to n. Now, minus 2 by 3R can be rewritten as minus 2 by 3R. This can be rewritten as, this can be rewritten in form. So, this is Sn, Sn which is equal to summation r is equal to 1 to n, 1 by 3r minus 2 plus 1 by 3n minus 1, 1 by 3r minus 1, and this can be rewritten as minus 1 by 3r. Plus 2 by 3r, which we can write it as minus 2 by 3r. We can rewrite this as 1 by 3r minus 1 by r plus 1 by 3r minus 1 by r. Correct. Because when you take LCM, you get minus 2 by 3r. This is the summation. We can rewrite this because 1 by 3r minus 1 by r gives you minus 2 by 3r. We are asked to show that this series is convergent and the sum is ln 3. So, when is the series going to be convergent? Only when nth partial sum converges. When is the sequence formed by nth partial sum converges? Only when the limit is finite and unique. So, let us try to find out what it is. So, let us simplify this. According to the previous notation, this is nothing but 1 by 3r minus 2, 1 by 3r minus 1 plus 1 by 3r. This is minus summation 1 to n 1 by r. This is nothing but according to previous notation, it is summation 1 by r is hn. So, this becomes h3n minus hn. So, what is h3n? It is nothing but gamma n, gamma 3n plus ln 3n. What is hn? Gamma n plus ln. Because what is hn? It is nothing but gamma n plus ln. What is this equal to? H3n means gamma 3n ln 3n. Now this is nothing but gamma 3n. Gamma 3n plus ln 3 plus ln n minus gamma n minus ln n. Ln n, ln n cancels. Gamma 3n plus ln n ln 3 minus gamma. This is Sn. Now, if we take limit n tending to infinity Sn, then this is limit n tending to infinity of gamma 3n plus ln 3 minus limit n tending to infinity of gamma n. And limit of this constant is itself. This is nothing but gamma. Limit of this is gamma ln 3 minus gamma. Therefore, it is equal to ln 3. Therefore, which is finite and unique. Because it is finite and unique, finite and unique. Therefore, we say that because it is finite and unique, we say that the sequence Sn is convergent. Because the sequence of nth partial sum is convergent, by definition, the infinite series is also convergent. And what is the sum value according to the definition of series? The sum is nothing but equal to the limit towards which this approaches, that limit itself becomes its sum. Therefore, the sum of the series is nothing but this. Therefore, we can conclude that this series, which is the rearrangement of the given series, original series is divergent, but after rearranging the terms, this is a rearrangement of the first one, first problem. It's nothing but rearrangement of this, and it is convergent, and the sum is equal to 3. Therefore, if the original series, if the given series is conditionally convergent, then the original series may be divergent, but after rearranging the terms, the series which we are going to get may be convergent and converges to a particular finite sum. That's what we are asking. So if the series is of positive terms, then automatically the rearrangement of the series is convergent if the original series is convergent. But whereas the nature of the series is altered if the series is rearranged in the particular term, original series is divergent. But whereas by rearranging the terms, we could establish that the series is convergent and the sum is equal to ln3 as defined.